Hi, I'm Gene Klavan, and these are the voices of Vista.
Someone who's willing, someone to care, someone who's needed and glad to be there, someone to give of himself for a year, a Vista volunteer.
Voices of Vista, starring William Shatner, brought to you as a public service by this station on behalf of volunteers in service to America. Vista, a people-to-people program run by volunteers who give a year of their lives to make the American dream come true for all Americans. I'll be here along with Bill Shatner to tell you what it is and what it takes to be a Vista volunteer. And now, our voice for Vista, William Shatner.
It's good to be here for Vista at your studio, and I'm looking forward to talking to you.
Thank you, Bill. I noticed last fall that William Shatner had a record come up, and without a doubt, well, with no exaggeration, I can only say it was just unique.
The record is out. It's called The Transformed Man. And nothing else, it is a unique idea. I had been asked when the series started, and I started to become popular as William Shatner, not as an actor that people might have spotted on television, began to get requests to be on conversation shows, you know, shows similar to this one for Vista, for example. And they would say, what would you like to do, you know, other than just talk? And people could sing and people could tell jokes. And I really couldn't do any of those things. I was merely qualified as a dramatic actor. And so I went back to some of the things that I perhaps could do, and that was Shakespeare. And so I would, on these conversation shows, do a soliloquy from one of the big soliloquies.
Will you, because it is so unusual the way you handle this on the record, will you, instead of explaining how you did it, will you do one for us now?
I'd love to. I was going to explain how the idea came about, but in essence, that's right. Let me do something like I would do on the conversation show. We'll do To Be or Not to Be, for example, the Hamlet thing. The music that you'll hear backing me in Hamlet was written, conducted and arranged by Don Ralke, a marvelous man, and you listen to Be or Not to Be combined with a song which was a very good year, again an original arrangement and my own interpretation. You listen to both these things I'll do for you now, and we'll talk a little more afterwards.
William Shatner, our voice for Vista, performs Hamlet. And it was a very good year.
Hamlet's endurance has reached the breaking point. His father has been murdered. His mother, whom he loves dearly, has married her dead husband's brother. Moreover, his sweetheart, Ophelia, has been acting very strangely. He senses that she does not love him anymore. Now, he's all alone. The world that he knew is shattered. His black mood of despair is deepened by his inability to act, to do something to change the situation. Now he ponders whether to continue living or to take his own life. To be or not to be, that is the question. Whether 'tis nobler in the mind to suffer the slings and arrows of outrageous fortune, or to take arms against a sea of troubles and by opposing end them. To die, to sleep, no more. And by a sleep to say we end the heartache and the thousand natural shocks that flesh is heir to, 'tis a consummation devoutly to be wished. To die, to sleep. To sleep, perchance to dream. Aye, there's the rub, for in that sleep of death what dreams may come when we have shuffled off this mortal coil must give us pause. There's the respect that makes calamity of so long life. For who would bear the whips and scorns of time, the oppressor's wrong, the proud man's contumely, the pangs of despised love, the law's delay, the insolence of office, and the spurns that patient merit of the unworthy takes, when he himself might his quietus make with a bare bodkin? Who would fardels bear to grunt and sweat under a weary life? But that the dread of something after death, the undiscovered country from whose bourne no traveler returns, puzzles the will and makes us rather bear those ills we have than fly to others we know not of. Thus, conscience doth make cowards of us all, and thus the native hue of resolution is sicklied o'er with the pale cast of thought. And enterprises of great pitch and moment, with this regard their currents turn awry, and lose the name of action. I was 17. It was a very good year. It was a very good year for small town girls and soft summer nights. We'd hide from the lights on the village green when I was 17. When I was 21, it was a very good year. It was a very good year for city girls who lived up the stair with perfumed hair that came undone when I was 21. When I was 35, it was a very good year. It was a very good year for blue-blooded girls of independent means. We'd ride in limousines, their chauffeurs would drive. When I was 35. Now the days are short. I'm in the autumn of the year. And now I think of my life as vintage wine from fine old kegs. From the brim to the dregs, it poured sweet and clear. It was a very good year.
William Shatner with an unusual combination of Shakespeare, and it was a very good year. Great words, great music. Words and lyrics written by men who had time to reflect on the human condition. How poor our lives would be if we didn't have time to sit back at times and reflect. But you know, that's part of poverty. Not having the time for what we call the higher things in life. If you're trapped in a city slum, if home is a poverty-stricken Indian reservation, or if you're a migrant worker endlessly on the move, going from one back-breaking job to another with no real home at all. If you're poor, you just don't have time for Shakespeare. You're too busy concentrating on where the next meal's coming from, how to get your kids some shoes. When you're poor, the business of simple survival fills all your waking hours. Some people throw up their hands in horror when they're confronted with the harsh facts of poverty. Other people roll up their sleeves and do something about it. They are Vista people, volunteers in service to America. Vista is a United States government program, and its volunteers are paid an astonishing salary. They get $50 a month. For $50 a month, they give a year of their lives to devote themselves full-time to helping people. Vista volunteers are people like you and me, people of all ages, all colors, all walks of life. If you would like to know more about this opportunity for you to be of tremendous service to people, write to Vista, V-I-S-T-A, Box K, Washington, D.C. I'm Gene Klavan, and you're listening to Voices of Vista. Now let's get back to our voice today for Vista, William Shatner. Bill, tell us, how does it come about that Bill Shatner is qualified to do leads in Star Trek and so many other major television series?
Well, qualified, that's a word open for interpretation, but I appreciate the compliment. I started a long time ago in Canada, in Montreal, my hometown. And I worked in amateur theaters there, and professional radio, college, university plays and musicals, and found that instead of getting tired at a job that I might have worked at part-time during the summer or after school hours, I found that I could work 18, 20 hours a day on theatrical jobs and not get tired. So I decided, much to my parents' astonishment and apprehension, that I'd give being an actor a whirl. And so when I graduated from McGill University in Montreal, I went immediately into professional theater. I had put myself through university on radio, on the salaries that I earned on radio, and I found that I was working in winter theaters in Ottawa, at the Canadian Repertory Theater there, and in summer theaters in Montreal. For about 2 years, I went back and forth. And then I went to Stratford and with Tyrone Guthrie, and I spent 3 years in Stratford doing Shakespeare there, and television and radio in Toronto. So altogether, my career in Canada spanned about 5 years. I moved to New York with a play that by Marlowe called Tamburlaine. And to make a long story short, I stayed in New York and alternated between New York and Los Angeles for now a vast number of years, a legendary number of years.
So obviously, Bill Shatner is a theater-trained television actor.
Yes, if anything qualifies me for playing on television or in movies nowadays, it's... I can't do anything else.
Now, tell us more about this record. Whose tremendous idea was that?
Well, as I was saying, the Shakespeare came to me naturally. It was the only thing I felt qualified to do. And I would do this on a conversation show every time I was asked. And the response was terrific. One of the shows, a show called The Woody Woodbury Show, the first time I did it, first time I did the Shakespeare, they asked me to come back shortly afterwards, saying that their response on the Shakespeare was far more, the write-in response was far more than anything else they'd ever had, and which included rock and roll groups, modern singers, comics. The response to the Shakespeare told them that they should get me back, and I subsequently was there three times and did three different monologues. Well, it occurred to me that maybe I should try and sing. I had been connected with musicals at the university, and I'd loved music, and I wanted to sing, and I'd studied singing a number of times, but never really jumped the hurdle of doing it professionally. So I started to study singing with a young fellow by the name of Cliff Ralke, who it turns out was the son of Don Ralke, the arranger who had a number of hit records on. Well, I still didn't feel qualified enough to sustain notes like Bob Goulet, for example, but I felt qualified to interpret a song. And so with conversations with Cliff and Don, and a third element, or fourth element, a poet by the name of Frank Davenport came into the being. He was introduced to me by the Ralkes. Frank Davenport wrote the major original piece of poetry in this record called The Transformed Man, from which the record takes its name. He became an integral part of the unit so that in conversations, this central idea of combining Shakespeare and song, the selection of material, how to interpret it, the editing of it, was done by Don, by Frank, and by myself.
Very exciting, Bill. Could you give us an example of your poet's work?
Yes, I'd like to do for you now, and for all those people who are listening with an idea that maybe Vista means something to them, that maybe Vista can offer them something meaningful in their life, more meaningful than the day-to-day exchange of money and prosaic ideas. Maybe Vista can give them a feeling of well-being, can do more for them than they will do for the people at large. I'd like to perform for you this piece of poetry which suggests perhaps there's more to life than just the life in the city or the day-to-day existence that most of us lead. It's called The Transformed Man.
One day, just another day of organized happiness, like all the others. I closed all the doors behind me, and as a leaf drops from a tree, I quietly walked out of the life they had planned for me. Not once did regret clutch my hand. I left on the wings of instinct. I turned away from the city teeming with desperate and haggard faces, away from the peddlers of hate and vengeance, away from the clock that decrees time is money, away from the arrogant and infallible whose hands are stained with blood. All this I left far behind me, and as a moth seeks light, as water seeks water, I sought the purity of higher regions, where austere mountains thrust their faces towards the sun. There in my sanctuary, surrounded by the dignity of pines and the serenity of gray boulders, I let my eyes drink in the clarity of wind-swept skies. I felt the warmth of sun-drenched stone. I listened to all the sounds of the earth, and I waited, as calm as a hooded falcon, for the hand of faith to lift the darkness. Each new dawn flamed above the treetops and scattered white fleece about the skies, and the darkness came and pushed the red lip of sun below the horizon. I lost track of the days. To count them never occurred to me. Cutting myself adrift from the past and the future, I became immersed in the flow of the living moment, the eternal now. Then one day, in the split of a moment, the shutter within flashed open, and a gush of light flooded my being. I became as a pure crystal submerged in a translucent sea, and I knew that I had been awakened. I had touched the face of God.
William Shatner and the Transformed Man. You know, Bill, Vista is transforming men too, transforming despair into hope, need into fulfillment, indifference into interest. And as they work among the poor, Vista volunteers become transformed men too, with new insight, new understanding. To find out more about Vista, write Box K, Washington, D.C. And now, Bill Shatner, thank you so much for being with us today on Voices of Vista.
Thank you. And let me tell you, in the short time I have left, what a pleasure it has been to perform for you on behalf of the volunteers in service to America. I know for myself as a young actor, when I was a young actor, and when someone, some individual would lend me a helping hand so that the next step was not as difficult as the last step, how grateful and how appreciative, and how, now that I can look back on the first faltering steps as an actor, now that I can look back and realize how much good, how much help that hand was for me, I want to reach out and help some person myself. And I know that there are millions of people in America who, having been helped by some individual in their lives, would like to help somebody else, can do so by joining Vista.
Look, Bill, you've been so articulate, and there's so much material in your album I'd like to hear. I really like to hear the Henry V piece. So let me ask you, could we come back next week and do another Voices of Vista with William Shatner?
I'll tell you what we'll do. We'll open up next week's show the way the record opens up, with Henry V and his Once More Under the Breach, Dear Friends.
Then I'll see you next week.
You couldn't hold me back.
Bill Shatner, our Voice of Vista. If you like to find out more about Vista volunteers in service to America, drop a line to Vista, Box K, Washington, D.C. Our thanks once again to our guest, William Shatner, to the American Federation of Musicians, and to this station whose cooperation makes Voices of Vista possible. We'll be back next week with more of William Shatner. Join us then, won't you? This is Gene Klavan.
Love and peace and understanding are the keys to every door. Love and peace and understanding are the hopes we all live for. You can turn away if you want to and forget about the man who is living in the ghettos and who needs a helping hand. You should help if you can. Love and peace and understanding, love and peace and understanding, love and peace and understanding, love and peace.
Voices of Vista is an MA Mangum production.